So, we all know the maiden flight of Falcon Heavy is going to lift off in around a month time. We're very excited about it. However, there are a lot of rumors flowing around spreading inaccurate information. So this video is my attempt to put everything I know about that launch together and share with you some of my thoughts on it. I'm Lei, let's get started. First of all, the upcoming launch in January will be the first launch of Falcon Heavy. Equipped with 27 Merlin engine, it is capable of producing 5.1 million pounds of thrust at liftoff. This is twice as powerful as the next most powerful rocket available today, the United Launch Alliance's Delta IV Heavy. During the maiden launch, Falcon Heavy will be firing at 92% maximum power. This launch is guaranteed to be exciting, and here is why. Other than the fact that the vehicle is going to Mars with an original roadster on it, comparing to Falcon 9 launches, there will be far more separation and landing events to look out for. From an engineering standpoint, these separation and landing events increase the risk factor of the launch, making Falcon Heavy's maiden launch much harder than any Falcon 9 launches. However, from an audience perspective, I'm sure we wouldn't mind watching SpaceX overcoming an even greater challenge. In less than 10 minutes, the Falcon Heavy will lift off with all 27 Merlin engines lighted. Soon after the liftoff, Falcon Heavy will perform a side booster cutoff and jettison, followed by a boostback burn, a re-entry burn, and a landing burn before the side boosters can both safely return to Cape Canaveral. A short while after, probably when the side boosters are re-entering the Earth atmosphere, the call booster will cut off and separate from the second stage and go through similar phases before landing on the autonomous spaceport drone ship named Of Course I Still Love You. How romantic is the name? If this still isn't exciting enough for you, I'm not done yet, because this mission is not completed before Tesla Roadster successfully sets its course to Mars. After separating with the core booster, the fairings will jettison and the second stage with one Merlin engine will start firing. This will accelerate the vehicle to reach the desired low Earth orbit. And this is when things get a little bit tricky, because in order to go to Mars, the second stage will need to find the right timing to fire again. And possibly again, and again, and again, and again, and again. The reason why I said again and again and again and again and again and again is that in the case of the ISRO's Mars mission, it took the ISRO 6 orbit-raising maneuvers and over 20 days before completing transmars injection. Lucky for us, I don't think it's gonna be the case for the upcoming Falcon launch, as Falcon Heavy is a much more powerful vehicle. Possibly, there won't be any orbit-raising maneuvers, and the Roadster will embark on its transfer orbit in less than an hour after the liftoff, like NASA's Maven mission. During the Maven mission, the second stage coasted on the low Earth orbit for 27 minutes before performing a second burn to inject itself into the heliocentric Mars transfer orbit. So possibly the live stream of the event will be a little bit over an hour long, which will be exciting, of course. And now it's time to talk about the actual Mars transfer orbit. The Mars transfer orbit is called the Holmann transfer orbit, which traditionally involves two burns. The first is an acceleration burn to escape the lower Earth orbit and cruise all the way to Mars. The second burn, however, depends on the mission. If the vehicle were to orbit around Mars, the engines on the vehicle need to burn for a second time to decelerate so as to be captured by Mars gravity. However, we won't be seeing it during the first Falcon Heavy launch. Instead, the Midnight Cherry Roadster is going to fly by slash rendezvous with Mars possibly 8 to 10 months after the launch and continue to wander off into the deep space on a heliocentric orbit around the Sun. So, no, Elon is not going to drive the car on Mars, nor is the car going to rotate around Mars. It's just going to have some fun in the deep space wandering around listening to Space Oddity. Which is, if you think about it, really not bad for a retired car. Well, this is about it for the maiden launch of Falcon Heavy. However, before I end the video, let me quickly add something. First of all, this launch should not be undersold. It is an important launch for SpaceX and space exploration in general. After the launch in January, Falcon Heavy will be the most capable launch vehicle in the world. This puts Falcon Heavy in a very strategic place to compete with the Space Launch System for future resupply missions to the Deep Space Gateway near the Moon. For the uninitiated out there, Deep Space Gateway is a future international space station NASA is about to build near the Moon in the next decade. Also, For certain geostationary transfer orbit missions with heavier payloads, the Falcon 9 is not yet completely reusable. As you can see, the gray box shows SpaceX missions with no attempt to reuse its booster. With Falcon Heavy, however, I think we can eliminate the gray boxes altogether. Some of you mentioned in my previous video that Falcon Heavy is not going to fly much, especially with the Falcon 9 Block 5 coming up that is going to improve the payload capability of Falcon 9 significantly. I agree with that. However, Falcon Heavy, in my opinion, is very important strategically because it shows NASA, the American Air Force, and the world that SpaceX can take on any competition out there. As for the actual launch event, I think it's going to be extremely thrilling and satisfying to watch. I personally am looking forward to the possible simultaneous landing of the side boosters and to see SpaceX perform Transmars injection for the first time. Something interesting to think about, if everything goes according to plan, we might be seeing our relatives and friends doing the same Transmars injection maneuver on board the BFR to visit Mars in a few decades' time. Pretty exciting stuff. So overall, this is going to be a historical launch. Make sure to comment down below what do you think about the launch. Is there anything I forgot to mention in the video? Also, I've been thinking about something. How long do you think the battery of the roaster can sustain before it runs out of battery, blasting Space Oddity? Maybe Elon should install some solar panels on the car so that the song can be played for billions of years. Thanks for watching. I think we definitely should tweet to Elon about the solar panel thing. Alright, I'm Lei. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.